Today we begin the nuclear chemistry unit. Part one will be about nuclear radiation and types of nuclear radiation. There are three types of nuclear radiation: alpha, beta, and gamma radiation, named after the first three letters of the Greek alphabet by none other than Ernest Rutherford himself of the gold foil experiment, which discovered the nucleus of the atom. Some background. First of all, we need to understand some terms. Radioactivity is the process by which an unstable nuclei or nucleus becomes stable. And the nucleus of an atom is generally not considered when we're talking about general chemistry. Normally, we're talking about the electrons and the valence electrons, especially when we talk about a chemical reaction. But the nucleus of an atom can become unstable as well. And when that happens, to become stable, it needs to emit some of its energy or mass in the form of a particle, or as energy, as an electromagnetic wave or ray. Radiation is what we collectively call these particles or energy. In particular, we call it nuclear radiation. Radioactive decay is the process that happens when an unstable nucleus spontaneously emits some of this radiation, either in the form of a particle or a ray. The first type of radiation is the alpha particle. The alpha particle is a positively charged particle that contains two protons and two neutrons. It's positively charged because of the two protons, and it's emitted by an unstable nucleus. An alpha particle is identical to a helium nucleus, and in fact, all helium that occurs on Earth comes from alpha particles, from radioactive decay of larger elements. There's no naturally occurring helium on Earth. The two protons and two neutrons add up to a mass number of four. So when we're writing it, instead of using the alpha symbol, we very often use the helium nucleus symbol that we learned in nuclear notation. The 2+2 nucleons yields a mass number of four, and the two protons down here give it an atomic number of two. Alpha particles move at about 1/10 of the speed of light, so they're moving relatively slowly by nuclear radiation terms, and so they can be easily stopped. Certainly a sheet of aluminum foil would stop them, even a sheet of paper will stop them, and definitely your skin will stop alpha particles, which means when they're outside of your body, alpha particles are completely safe. You could even hold an alpha particle emitter in your hand, and it would cause no damage whatsoever. Now, alpha particles on the inside of the body are a different story because cell membranes and things like that can be damaged. So we certainly don't want any alpha particle emitters in our body, but on the outside, they're completely safe. Alpha decay occurs when we have an unstable nuclei. In this example, I've got plutonium-240, and it is going to decay by alpha emission. And when it spits out two protons and two neutrons, it loses four from its mass number. So it goes from 240 down to 236. It also loses two from its atomic number. So it goes from 94 down to 92. So we've got true transmutation where one element is becoming another element. That's the alchemist's dream, to transmute lead into gold. And we can, in fact, do that. We can turn lead into gold. The problem is it's so expensive that we would spend a fortune just trying to make a few tiny bits of gold, so it's not worth the money to try and get rich doing it that way. The next type of particle is a beta particle, represented by the second letter in the Greek alphabet, the letter beta. A beta particle is just an electron. However, it's a very special electron because it doesn't come from the energy levels or the electron cloud. It comes from the nucleus of an atom where electrons shouldn't be. It comes from basically the decomposition of a neutron. A neutron used to be thought, or originally was thought before Chadwick, to possibly be a proton and an electron combined together so that their charges would cancel out and we would have a neutral particle. And from this nuclear equation, it also looks like that. But it's actually not. And there is another particle that comes out during the decay called an antineutrino, which is an antimatter electron neutrino. Now, we're not going to discuss these in this class, but a neutron is its own particle. It does exist independently of protons and neutrons. Beta particles move near the speed of light. They penetrate about 100 times greater than alpha particles because of that high energy. They can be stopped by a few sheets of aluminum foil or by your hand. They can, on unprotected skin, cause burns similar to like a sunburn, but they can't go much deeper than the outer layers of your body, so they don't penetrate very deeply, but a lot more deeply than alpha particles. In this example of beta decay, we have a carbon-14, a naturally occurring isotope of carbon, which is radioactive, and carbon-14 has a couple more neutrons than the carbon-12 that is normally present. One of those neutrons decays into a proton and an electron. And when that happens, since for mass number, a proton and a neutron are the same, the mass number doesn't change. So we have a 14 here for carbon and a 14 here. But the atomic number does change. The atomic number actually goes up. So it goes from 6 for carbon up to 7 for nitrogen. So with beta radiation, we have the atomic number going up by 1. Alpha radiation, remember, it went down by 2. The third type of radiation is gamma radiation. Gamma radiation is not a particle. It's a ray, like a ray of light or a radio wave or an X-ray or even infrared radiation, like you feel on your skin when you are near something that's hot. It's ionizing, which means it can create ions, and that's because it has such a high energy. It's extremely high frequency and extremely high energy, and it can penetrate not only that sheet of paper in your skin, but also quite a bit of concrete and even lead. Gamma rays are very high energy electromagnetic waves. They don't have mass or electric charge because, remember, they are not particles. They are just waves similar to light, but they just have a whole lot more energy and a much higher frequency. We write them in nuclear notation like this, with a 0 for the mass number and a 0 for the atomic number, to indicate that they have no effect on the actual composition of the nucleus. They're just the nucleus settling down into a more stable state. They're the most penetrating of all the types of radiation because of their extremely high energy. They can be stopped if you have enough concrete, usually a couple of feet of it, or several inches of lead. In this diagram right here, I'm representing an unstable nucleus of helium-3, which may have just been produced by fusion in the sun or in a particle accelerator. And you can see that the particles, the two protons and the neutron, are kind of apart from each other because they're excited. They're vibrating and they can't settle down. But what happens is they can emit a photon of light, and that gets rid of that extra energy and allows them to settle down into a stable nucleus. That photon of light that's coming from the nucleus of the atom is the gamma ray. Any light that comes, or any electromagnetic radiation from the nucleus of an atom, is technically a gamma ray, no matter what its frequency. But gamma rays are typically extremely high frequency and extremely high energy, and of course very, very damaging. This representation is of the penetrating power, which you should know. Alpha radiation, the least penetrating, can be stopped by something even as thin as a sheet of paper. Beta radiation would go through that, but would have difficulty getting through your skin. Gamma rays, of course, can go through the paper, skin, a glass of water, and quite a bit of concrete before they eventually stop. There's another type of radiation on this diagram here as well, neutron radiation, which is not part of these big three that we've talked about. Neutron radiation we will discuss when we talk about fission and fusion. Fission results in the release of several neutrons, which continue the reaction. And neutron radiation is somewhere in between beta and gamma in terms of its penetrating power. It can go through your body and is stopped by significant volumes of water. So in summary, we've got this table here. Alpha particles, represented by the Greek letter alpha, the same as a helium nucleus. Their composition, 2 protons and 2 neutrons. Their charge is +2, and they have a very low penetrating power. Beta radiation, represented by the Greek letter beta, and in nuclear notation by the small e with the 0 on top, indicating it has no effect on the mass number, and -1, indicating that the effect of the atomic number is that the atomic number goes up by 1. It is an electron with a negative one charge, and its penetrating power is about 100 times greater than that of alpha particles. The last is the gamma ray, which is not a particle itself. It has 0, 0, and the letter gamma, the 0 representing that it has no effect on mass number or atomic number. It is an electromagnetic wave, so therefore it has no charge, and its penetrating power is very great. So here's a summary of the three types. Alpha particles, a positively charged particle like a helium nucleus. A beta particle is an electron that is caused by the decay of a neutron into a proton and an electron. And a gamma ray, which is a high-energy electromagnetic ray. It has no mass, and it's the result of an excited nucleus settling down by releasing some energy.